calm and charismatic, Jim McKenzie is a creative genius on so many levels. Like a lot of great creatives, there are many strands to what McKenzie is able to put his hand to. And also, like many great creatives, he is very good at linking these things together in his work. I think on YouTube at least, McKenzie is best known for his cinematic art process videos, many of which are created with stop-motion animation. But back in 2011, before any of this came to light, McKenzie was a director and designer at Nathan Love in New York, which later became Aardman Nathan Love in 2015. As well as this, he was also teaching animation and storytelling at the School of Visual Arts. He definitely likes to keep busy. And later, he went on to discover fine art and began using his daily commute to work to create personal projects that were completely his own. But back to his stop-motion process videos. These videos document his sculpts in the most imaginative and perfect ways, with incredibly slick stop-motion animation too. So slick. The detail and quality of these pieces is honestly phenomenal, and mesmerising, and, well, just wonderful in every way. McKenzie shot up the YouTube ranks in 2016 with The Scarecrow, a short film documenting the whole two-year-long process of creating a character sketch through to a finished sculpture.
I saved up all this money to buy this camera just so I could shoot the process of this. And it's about a 3-minute video, but it just shows all of the tiny details that go into this piece that you might not see from just looking at a picture of it.
Just like The Scarecrow, Jim McKenzie is outstanding in his field. Sorry, I had to fit that line in somewhere. And yes, I know it was bad. Okay, let's move on. The success of this film was pivotal in McKenzie realizing that being an independent artist really was possible. Something he had thought about and planned for many years. So let's learn more about his process. How McKenzie creates his art sculptures. He has been quoted saying in many interviews that at the center of every successful piece of work is a core of rubbish.
I love Quentin Tarantino, so I had to do a Quentin piece. I made this with a bunch of garbage and some clay.
He builds his clay masterpieces around anything and everything that he can find, from stuff in the actual bin to things lying around his home. He uses this to mold a central base, which is then clad in clay. And not just any clay. McKenzie's work is magic, in part, because clay of that same name is his material of choice. And yes, that is really what it's called. Magic clay. And well,
it's hard as a rock.
It's a two-part epoxy resin substance, which apparently stinks and is a little toxic, but it definitely yields results. The clay has a work time of around an hour before it sets. And to take away and add details, McKenzie uses a Dremel, a powered device with interchangeable heads. But what can we learn from McKenzie as a person? Well, he is also quoted as saying his goals and dreams change from day to day, something I think a lot of us can relate to. And it reminds me of something someone said at my own graduation, that no path in life is the same. And we all tread really wiggly, sometimes random, series of events in life. But the later along the line, things seem to come together and make more sense. McKenzie still doesn't completely know where he will end up, but all the little bends and turns in his path so far have led him to an amazing hybrid place where he can combine lots of talents all at once into a single piece of art. Furthering this point, variety really does make the spice of life. If you have multiple talents and interests, there will never be a dull day. And it will make your working life much more enjoyable too. Yes, of course, be a specialist at something, but also have a couple of backup skills which you are good enough at to dip in and out of too. Being able to jump from one technique or art form to another can really help to keep your work fresh. So what else makes McKenzie stand out? Well, at every point in his journey to date, he has had a fairly clear vision of what he is setting out to achieve. And that clarity has meant that he could surround himself with the right kind of people. There's that saying, isn't there, that you are the average of the five people you spend the most time with. I feel like seeking out people you admire is a great way to become even greater yourself. Mackenzie is also a sort of example of how hard work behind the scenes can propel you to great heights. Because on the occasion where a lucky meeting or opportunity might present itself, you are able to capitalize on that event and really run with it because you have the talent to back it up. So, essentially, work hard, hone your craft, surround yourself with the best people you can, those that will really champion your art and help you to be your best creative self. Don't worry if life doesn't make sense right now. For 99% of us, it won't. But later on it might. So just enjoy where you are at and make the most of learning anything and everything that you can, related or unrelated to your field of expertise. No skill learned is ever wasted. Trust me, I've tried a million different things and jobs, and it is only recently for me too that things are starting to work harmoniously together. But all those random things I did are now making much more sense to me too. Like many of us, Mackenzie's inspirations can come from anything around him. A reminder to keep our eyes and imagination open at all times. Who knows when a crazy good idea might just plop into your head. Another point Mackenzie has raised in at least one interview that I read was that it is easy to look at his body of work in awe and to put the greatness that he has created on a pedestal. But like each and every one of us that display our work online, what others see is a curated feed of life and work. It is not everything, and we are all human, and we all have less good days, and we all suffer from those human things. Greatness is something we should all aspire for, and is possible for anyone who can dream it and work hard to realise it. But along the way, there will be doubts and failures. But these are moments to propel you further. We all have them, and we can all move through them. In a similar vein, creative block strikes even the best of us, Mackenzie included. But his advice, which I second in motion, is to work through the discomfort. Document your ideas in a book, on post-it notes, or in your phone. And when an empty head arrives, fill it with something new, a different idea, to work around the block and re-energise your imagination. Ultimately, Mackenzie has just always done what he has loved doing. And things have evolved and changed and become new things, and well, it's just a perfect example of working hard and trusting the universe in the boldest way possible. He's one of my favourite people on the internet. So put your work out there and manifest your future too. I love making these Creator Spotlight videos because they are a way for me to combine and share another part of me as well, to motivate and inspire. I love observing and evaluating the work of others to maybe help you see what is possible and show you that you can get there too. So trust yourself, work hard and dream big. You've got this. If you enjoyed this video, you might also enjoy the other two videos on screen now. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel.